In this episode, my friends and I go on a JDM road trip to see castles and cherry blossoms, drive some amazing roads, do some tunnel pulls, stuff our faces at a Japanese family restaurant, and go hunting for some epic views. Basically, just a typical day in our JDM life. Hey, I'm Albo. I came to Japan as an English teacher, then moved near Tokyo to pursue my passions. I became a filmmaker because I love cars, Japanese culture, and a good story. I'm lucky enough to live the JDM dream, and so my videos are about my car life in Japan, where I go to car meets and visit shops, do track days and toge runs, build and review cars, and shoot vlogs, short films, and documentaries about Japan's car culture and history. Join me and my friends on our adventures and find out what it's really like in the land of the rising sun. So hop in, fasten your seatbelts, and enjoy the ride. Hey guys, so today we are at our usual spot. We're gonna be driving in Hakone. I'm here with my friends, and with Niku-chan is here too. There she is. Let's go say hi to everybody. Yeah, so let's just get going. Okay, so of course we got the S2000. This really, really nice R33, which has been refreshed. Caps Civic. We also have Andres GTR. Jason's R34, and over here this Ferrari and this Roadster. These are basically the same car.
We are doing best motoring today, including one Ferrari.
Which is faster on the toge?
Actually, the fastest car technically would be that, because it's the lightest.
Probably.
The lightest car is always the fastest.
You know, it would be the lightest.
Yeah.
Niku-chan's
the lightest. Oh yeah.
I'm the dad now.
So what's the plan today, Cap?
The plan is to go to Atami, which is a coastal line.
Ooh, Izu.
The beginning of Izu. Yep. Probably going to see some really nice views from the cliff. Sakura's probably going to go up later. And
nice.
We'll do Sakura Drive coming down Hakone.
Nice.
And we've got three new friends here today with us from TCC.
So can you introduce?
Yeah, we've got Victor. He's the one that drives this Ferrari.
Yeah, right. I thought it was a Miata. I can't tell the difference. I'm sorry. Yeah.
Same color. It's just a bigger Miata.
Yeah, it is.
And we got Robin.
Hey, Robin.
Singapore, right? And he's got an ND.
He's got the Ferrari. Wait, he's hang on. I keep confusing them. Okay. Sorry. And then Adam with the R33.
R33.
And then Japonic with the T-shirt.
Yes. Well, that's not his car. It looks like his car.
It looks like a passenger today.
Yeah. Oh, MR2. That's rare. That's rare. Can we check out your R33 real quick?
Sure.
Man, it's sick. It just had like a refresh, right?
Yeah. Body refresh.
So these days I've been asking folks, like, how did you find your job in Japan?
All right. So I've been doing automation and orchestration tech in telecoms for the last probably close to 10 years. And I'm from Australia. And there was a big project that was kicking off from my company. The company I work with for the last 10 years is a multinational. And so actually I just one day got a call and said, hey, there's a project in Japan. We don't have the skills here. Do you want to come over?
Wow.
And they didn't know that I like Japan or I like Japanese cars or something. So it was real like...
It worked out.
You know, yeah. I said, yeah, sure. And then
Nice. Sounds kind of similar to Jason.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Turns out Jason and I are neighbors. We didn't know.
No.
We're like literally
really?
Across the street from each other.
Are you serious?
Yeah, not even kidding. Yeah.
I would say like what are the chances, but that's more like destiny. It's like you guys are fated to be friends, you know.
Yeah. At this R35
badges. Yeah, I saw that. I saw that too. I saw that detail.
Some people don't like that. Yeah.
I mean, it's OEM, so yeah. I like it. And I think you did something with the front bumper too, right?
Yeah, so this is from the R34 V-spec.
Wow. And you had it basically molded in?
Right.
That's so perfect.
Usually you see these fitted and there's a cutout and just stuck on.
Yeah.
But this guy, Kanazawa-san, he's a bit of a magician, so he basically... He merged the plastic and the fiber because that was an FRP and put it all together.
This is from R34, that vent.
To your star fighters, gentlemen.
Okay. All right.
We going?
Should we, yep. All right, Niku-chan, you gonna drive?
Thank you, Sam. Here you go. Here you go.
No, thank you.
Yeah, kind of cool. Kind of cool. Okay. No, thank you. Okay. Thanks, Adam. Okay, so we're gonna start driving, so it should be fun. Let's get going. Okay, it's our first sighting of the Sakura.
We'll wait for rail scout to give us a signal.
Okay, we are here.
Matt, roger that. Watching out for traffic before moving on.
What a nice view. Beautiful day. What a cute dog. What a cute girl.
Hello, girl.
Whoa, this is a view. Look at the waves. Getting pictures for his Tinder.
Yeah, look at it. The mask.
Yeah, right.
There you go. Yeah, the different angles. Yeah.
Where's the castle? Oh, here it is.
What an epic view, though. Like, not just the castle, right? And not just this view, but look at that.
I feel like Tony Stark. This Tony Stark has that kind of house.
Right there? Yeah, you're right. It does kind of look like the Tony Stark's house.
I'm just watching Iron Man.
Oh my gosh, what a view. This looks like from Count of Monte Cristo.
It does. Or from Pirates of the Caribbean.
Yes.
Or whatever.
It doesn't look like Japan at all.
It
like, this
look
is
like
so almost Mediterranean.
It is actually based on a Mediterranean city. That little bit over there at the end, if you watch the movie Casino Royale at the last scene where James Bond encounters some bad guys, and also from episode 2 of Star Wars where Padme and Anakin get married, it's actually located scenically in Lake Como. So that section over there is actually loosely based on that theme. So when there's a coastline and you've got like the rocks coming in, there's a cove actually down there which goes inside, is like a pirate's cove. So this entire section is just...
And then this castle, look at that.
That is
massive. What's the name of that castle?
Atami Castle. It's historically not accurate. It's just a modern castle.
Oh, I see. It's a modern reconstruction.
Not a reconstruction. It's me.
Oh, okay.
It's just me. It's not a historic castle. At all.
It's very Do you want to live in a castle?
No.
Want to be a princess?
I don't want to be a Japanese princess.
All right, we're going to get some food at Gusto. Everyone's standing around Jason's beautiful GTR.
Nope.
You know what I love most? I love this.
I'm not too,
it's
I'm
gonna
too,
get fucked up
here.
It's so good.
Hey,
are now getting food at Gusto. Can I check the menu, please?
Sure.
Here we go. All right. This is quite
for you,
nice.
Since you're a big baby.
Yeah, it's you.
Yeah, it's
wait,
you.
Hang on.
No,
hang on. That's me.
Okay, I'm kidding.
Oh, okay. Yeah, but.
Hey guys, this is my menu.
Yeah. Now this looks like you.
Well, you know, you're kind of childish.
Then,
so.
Then this is Kaneko.
Hey, I have a
maid. Wait, watch this.
Oh man, I've seen worse things in my life. Oh, sorry.
All right.
No, I'm gonna get my stuff.
I wish I could get this. That actually looks really good.
Are you serious?
No, dude, look at it. Look at this one. Get pancakes. Get everything. Pizza.
Oh man, it's so confusing. Deliveries in English.
Say again.
When he hits 1,000 subscribers, he's gonna upgrade his GTR to 2017 model.
Well, think about it.
All right, everybody, subscribe to his channel right now. We can do it in one video. Yeah, you gotta do it. This guy keeps talking about McLaren, actually.
Yeah, McLaren, man. There's something nice about it.
Yeah, it's like you hate money. You're just like.
Yeah. No. Sorry, we're not doing any better.
That looks
we're
so good. We all got the same thing here.
Next time we go to the karaoke place in Awara.
This is the same place.
Yeah, it's karaoke.
They have a collaboration. Yes.
Yeah.
It's the same thing.
But better.
Okay, it's my favorite. Let's see if it's good here.
No!
It's okay.
You guys,
I'll take it.
Yeah.
No. Good.
I
ordered. Looks so good, man. This combination right here.
You gotta get one.
R34?
R32?
I'll wait for R36. I don't know if I asked in a video before, but what was your, like, how did you, like, come to Japan?
I just came and looked for a job. For your viewers, it's different, right? I already had work experience and then I moved here to look for the same type of job that I already have. I applied directly with companies. A lot of websites, they have listings on their website, all the job listings, so I applied directly.
Because you're not a programmer, right?
Yeah, there's like different types of programmers. I'm a database programmer, engineer type of role, data analytics, business intelligence.
If young kids maybe going to college, what field do you think they should study?
Tech field is pretty good. You can work in any country because it's pretty much the same, and it transfers also to different industries. All the industries have the same type of tech jobs.
You know, if they're gonna learn programming language, like what should they learn?
You can learn all that by yourself. There's so many resources online. The important thing is to just get a job experience. A lot of those viewers may think of coming to Japan and teaching English. But there are limits to
for sure.
Yeah.
There's a ceiling to it. Yeah.
I do know people that have moved to Japan teaching English and then changed to a different career or industry, like Apple. But my way was a different way, where I was already working and then moved to Japan to continue doing that same type of job.
Cool. Yeah, it's like thanks.
We gotta go.
I think so. So, yep. Okay. We'll just hop in the car. Thanks. Yep. Okay, there's another spot down here. Let's see where it leads. Oh yeah, now actually we are here by our Nesto parking area. Okay. Oh, is she okay? Okay. Whoa, 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 yeah. Where are we going? Oh. Oh, wow, we're back. It's easy. Oh, yeah, careful. Whew. I love the anime sticker on this. Somehow it suits it.
I love that he puts it on a Ferrari.
Yeah. These are basically the same car. They're so similar. Even the taillights. Okay guys, I'm gonna end the video here. Already been filming all day, and after this we're just gonna head back. So, great day out with the guys. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we'll catch you in the next one. Peace.
Today was a really fun, chill day with my fiance and the Super JDM Bros. It was a ton of fun to make this video, and so please let me know in the comments if you want to see more road trip videos like this around Japan in addition to the other types of videos. And let me know what other kind of videos you want to see. Make sure to follow me on Instagram for more behind the scenes content, and check out my podcast for interviews with cool people and long talks with my friends. Keep watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.